Alright, I'm back. Nothing too much to report. I'll just see where I get to today. So I'm gonna go ahead and mute myself.
It's me, Gareth. Do you have a moment?
Were you calling me, Gareth?
I was. After you helped me with that Fupa feather and potions, I reckoned you might be just the person I need. You see, I have an idea for a fizzing, Wisby-inspired beverage, but I'm missing a key ingredient.
You and your concoctions. I don't know how you come up with these things.
It's a gift, truly. So, I suspect the key ingredient in fizzing Wisbys is dried billywig stings. I heard there's a store of them in Honeyduke's cellar. I'd get them myself, but my Aunt Matilda has her eye on me. Thinks I need to focus on potions class for a while, not for my own brews. I was hoping you could follow a secret passage to Honeyduke's cellar and grab a few dried billywig stings for me.
Sounds simple enough. And who wouldn't want to go to Honeyduke's?
Ah, brilliant. Thank you. The passage is hidden behind the statue of a one-eyed witch in the third floor corridor. Just tap it with your wand and say, Descendium.
Couldn't you have someone buy the dried billywigs things?
They're not for sale, and you never know when the cellar's going to be locked. So, the reliable way in and out is through the secret entrance.
Are you asking me to steal from a shop?
Goodness! It's not as if I'm asking you to rob Gringotts. Honeydukes is more than enough, and I only need a few. It's a sweets ingredient. They won't be missed, trust me.
I'll see what I can do, Gareth.
Fair enough. You shall be the first one to taste my newest brew if you can be of help. Perhaps I can convince a meat to help me with my potions homework, get my aunt to loosen her reins a bit.
I'll need to get those dried billywigs things for Gareth if he's to finish his latest concoction. A one-eyed witch statue shouldn't be too hard to find. This looks like the right statue. Now, what was the password? Descendium! C- goodness. Who knew this was all down here?
Revelio.
A lift. Must be how I get down. Looks broken, though.
Accio. Revelio. Repairer.
I need to fix the lift before I can use it. That seems to have done the trick. This castle will never cease to surprise me.
Revelio. Revelio.
I'm trapped. How am I supposed to get out of here?
Confringo. Revelio. Levioso.
I'm going to have to get past this.
Levioso. Accio. Revelio. Levioso. Repairer. Levioso. Reparo. Confringo. Confringo. Protego. Reparo. Huh?
One more to go and I'll make it across.
Leviosa!
Something is getting in the way of that platform.
Accio! Leviosa!
Aha! Got it.
Revelio! Lumos! Revelio! Lumos!
This must be the way out.
Lumos!
I need to find a way to open that gate. Sweet. Must be close to Honeydukes.
Revelio.
Hogsmeade, here I come. Honeydukes. I can smell the chocolate. Now, where would I find the dried billywig stings for Gareth?
Revelio. Lumos. Revelio.
Have the dried billywigs things. Now back to Gareth. I can only imagine how his new recipe's going to turn out.
Off on another adventure, are we?
Revelio. Lumos. Repairer.
Thank you. Hello, Gareth. I have those dried billywigs things.
You got them!
Incredible.
Happy to help. Here you go.
This is brilliant! Can't wait to get started. Thank you again. I'll let you know when I brewed my first batch of fizzing whiz beer.
Hello again, Mr. Moon.
Oh, I was hoping to see you again, my young friend. Gladwyn Moon, Hogwarts caretaker, at your service. First, please allow me to apologize if I seemed a bit unsteady when we last met. I'm afraid I had a rather disconcerting encounter. Although I hear your visit to Hogsmeade was even more eventful than mine.
I suppose you could call it eventful. I certainly wasn't expecting a troll attack.
Oh, of course not! From what I understand, the village was lucky you were there. In fact, my recent visit to Hogsmeade is the reason I was hoping to bump into you. I could use your help with something. Do you see that curious statue over there? Watch what happens when that light changes from day to night. If you wouldn't mind humouring me for a moment, see if you can remove the moon from the statue. Ooh, odd little contraptions, aren't they? It seems the statue vanishes once the moon is removed. Which, incidentally, can only be done at night. Why don't you hold on to that one for now, and I'll explain more as we walk. Ever since that fateful day in the village, those curious statues have begun appearing about the castle. A fair number have been strewn around Hogsmeade. Someone, it seems, is trying to torment me. You see, that day in Hogsmeade, I turned a corner and came face to face with a boggart, or shapeshifter, if you will, which takes the form of whatever scares you most. This one took the form of a demiguise.
A demiguise?
Yes! Terrifying creature that can see the future.
Wholly unnerving. I encountered one when I was a lad in Korea. Terrible experience. Those statues are demiguises.
Revelio.
The moons, I assume, are an uninspired play on my name. Some jackanapes used a boggart to learn my greatest fear and use it against me. I have my suspicion as to the scoundrel or scoundrels responsible. It is my hope that they will slip up and reveal themselves as the statues disappear. That is why I need your help in removing the statues.
Why me?
A couple of reasons, frankly. First, your daring do against those trolls in Hogsmeade has gained you a reputation for fearlessness. Second, as macabre and hideous as a demiguise is, most would find my fear of them unwarranted. You, however, have seen how they affect me. I'm at my wit's end, young friend. I simply can't bring myself to go near them. In fact, I know of two statues right here in the faculty tower. Perhaps you could start simply by removing them so I can go about my evening duties.
I'd be glad to help you, Mr. Moon.
Oh, I knew I could count on you. First, you know how to cast a disillusionment charm, correct? You'll want to do that before wandering the tower at night. Next, you'll notice that the door is locked. However will you get in? Alohomora, that's how.
But what about curfew?
Curfew? Oh, tosh. I sense you're a bit like me when I was your age. Oh, the school was my oyster. And I took advantage of it. Oh, everyone loved me for it. Oh, those were the days. Now, you'll find one statue in the prefect's bathroom and the other in the hospital wing. Good luck. Oh, and thank you.
Alohomora. Alohomora.
You're in. Remember, use a disillusionment charm so no one claps eyes on you. This is a restricted area of the castle.
Revelio.
Poorly, I'd say.
Is that so?
We're raising a generation of coddled people.
Revelio. This must be the prefect's bathroom. Hello, Hamora.
If the ministry would allow them to have one. One of those things or hell, I suppose. Anyway, I'm not afraid of a goblin rebellion. My marks in Professor Hecate's class are superb. I don't think that's what that class is for.
I've always said that trouble broadens the mind.
Revelio.
Not at the moment, no. Plenty of other perils and pitfalls to send them my way, though.
Well, I suppose I should begin my rounds now.
I suppose Professor Black knows best, but the students are terrible.
I had planned to bet a few galleons on Hufflepuff this season.
Hufflepuff? Not Ravenclaw?
I know when I see
Revelio. Revelio. Hello, Mr. Moon. I have the moons you asked me to collect.
Oh, goodness! You're as fearless as I'd hoped. An excellent start. If we can collect more, it may shed some light on who's behind all this. Of course, I first suspected Peeves. He drove the previous caretaker, Rancorous Carp, to an early retirement with his intolerable buffoonery. But that does not explain the boggart in Hogsmeade, does it? No. I am determined, with your help, to discover the identity of my tormentor.
It's definitely intriguing. I'd like to help you solve this mystery.
You, my friend, are a gentle person and a scholar. And I have something to offer in exchange for your assistance. Now, remember, the moons are only retrievable at night. Thus, I encourage you to use a disillusionment when necessary.
How many statues are there to find?
I don't know precisely, but I've spotted dozens. Seems they're everywhere I look. You have your work cut out for you, if you were to ever unravel their meaning.
You mentioned offering something in exchange for my assistance.
I did. Once you've brought me enough moons, I'll show you even more powerful forms of Alohomora. Not every lock is as easy to pick as the faculty towers.
Understood. I shall keep an eye out.
I appreciate that. Oh, and I knew you were the one to ask for help. Keep at it so we can solve this mystery.
Revelio.
Hello, friend. I wonder if you might stop by the Three Broomsticks when you can. I would like your help with something.
As I mentioned, my sister Anne misses Hogwarts, and she hasn't been herself lately. I'd like to take you up on your promise to visit her with me. I'm heading to Feldcroft soon, so I'll look forward to seeing you there.
Revelio.
Hogwarts. By the way, hope you're faring well with the blasting curse. It's still one of my favorites.
Now that you've attended Beasts class, I've asked Deke to assist you in using the room to further your studies in that regard. Please meet him there when you can.
I've not heard from my Uncle Roland in quite some time. I've been beside myself with worry. Could you meet me in the courtyard?
Aloha, Mora. Revelio.
Revelio. Lumos. Revelio. Revelio. Lumos. Revelio. Lumos. Revelio. Lumos. Revelio. Lumos. Revelio. Lumos.
What are you up to
Lumos.
Now?
Lumos. Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Revelio. Confringo. Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. 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 Revelio.
Alohomora. Revelio. Revelio.
Foolish child. Do you have any idea how many muggles the Ministry had to obliterate to cover up your actions? You could have been killed. You could have exposed us all. It will be you to blame.
Revelio.
Another selection for you all. This was composed long before any of us were even painted.
Revelio.
I cannot do this for all eternity.
Confringo.
What do you want?
Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio.
What do we have here? A demiguise.
Revelio.
Mind now, demiguys.
Revelio.
Lumos. Alohomora. Lumos.
Revelio.
Lumos.
Revelio.
Lumos.
Deke. Ah, Deke is so happy to see you. Deke noticed this bag in the room the other day. You must need it to help with your schoolwork. Deke has seen one of these before. Deke calls it a knapsack. Perfect for gathering and transporting beasts. Pleasant little breeze.
I have been thinking about something Professor Howen said in Beasts class, that I should study as many beasts as I can on my own time. She also mentioned that poachers have been active in the area. So, perhaps the beasts will be safer with us than out on their own.
Precisely what Deke was thinking. You see, the room knew exactly what you needed, and luckily, Deke can show you how to best use the knapsack and where. Come along, then. Our first stop will be beyond the castle grounds. We can leave now, or you can come and find Deke when you're ready to go.
I'd like to ask you about changing the room's ambience.
Of course. What sort of overall look most appeals to you?
Actually, perhaps another time.
Thank you.
I'm ready to learn how to use the knapsack.
Perfect! Deke loves an outing. A nasty poacher. Deke hated working for him. He did horrible things to beautiful beasts. Oh. It was during those days that Deke first saw a knapsack. It'll be nice to see one used for good. We have arrived. Deke enjoys coming here to watch the beasts, especially the Puffle of Puffskeins nearby. It will be nice to keep them safe. All you will need to do is get close, direct the open knapsack toward the Puffskein, and in it'll go.
All right. Hello, Deke. Can you remind me how to use the knapsack?
First, get close to the beast.
I managed to rescue a Puffskein.
You can rescue as many as the knapsack will hold. Poachers capture Puffskeins and, well, Deke isn't sure what they do with them. Deke is certain they will be safer with you. Now, not all beasts will be as simple to rescue as a Puffskein. Deke suggests you next find a beast that can fly. A Jobbernoll, perhaps.
All right. Where would I find one?
Deke knows of some to the west, nesting in a large tree overlooking Hogwarts. But we must be careful. Deke has seen poachers in the area recently. Deke will meet you there whenever you're ready.
Now, I'm only trying to help. Professor Howell will never believe this. Everything's all right now. castle.
Revelio. Sometimes it seems all roads lead to Hogsmeade.
Revelio.
It's always nice to see a familiar face. A pleasure doing business with you. Nothing like finding just the right thing, is there? Let me know if there's anything else I can do to help.
Off on another adventure, are we?
Revelio.
I won't rest until you're
ten finger.
Akio.
Revelio. You've one less follower, Ranrok. Revelio.
Confringo!
Revelio!
Confringo!
Merlin himself would be proud. Let's see what's up your sleeve this time, Merlin.
Revelio!
Abandoned long ago, no doubt.
You've heard quite enough, Varl.
Glacius!
I'll get that goblin helm back.
Akio!
You're the little sod that saved Treadwell.
The beasts around here can sleep a bit easier now.
Revelio.
Aloha, Mora.
Do cooperate, won't you? Who lived here, I wonder? No, you don't.
Revelio.
No need to be difficult. I mean you no harm.
Revelio. Revelio.
Lumos.
Come out. I'll check your pockets or you're dead.
Confringo.
You may want to.
Confringo!
Your little sons have saved trivial.
Accio!
What have you done? I'll get that goblin helm back.
Confringo!
You've heard quite enough of our ranks.
Accio!
Your poaching days are over.
Revelio!
Lumos. Lumos.
I know what that means.
Mother.
I dream of making a better world for me.
Surprised how many nibblers you could find down there.
Accio!
It seems we may have an intruder.
Confringo! Accio! Accio! Confringo!
Confringo! Not so tough now, are ya?
Confringo!
Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Does it get any more cozy than Hogsmeade? This place has seen better days.
Revelio. Revelio.
Travel.
Wonder who lives here.
Shane Bardolph thought dark magic was the answer. I reckon.
Excuse me, did you say something about Bardolph Beaumont?
I did. I don't think we've met. I'm Dorothy Sprottle. I was just worrying about Claire Beaumont's brother Bardolph, only he's gone missing. Rumor is he was seen in the forest practicing dark magic. Saw him myself near some ruins with Rookwood's lot I did. I fear he got himself into trouble with the Ashwinders, especially if he made them a promise he couldn't keep. I'd help search for him myself, but no one will risk encountering Ranrock's loyalists. They seem to be everywhere.
Why would Bardolph want to get involved with the Ashwinders?
Oh, he had a terrible run-in with Ranrock's loyalists. Changed him. He vowed never to feel powerless again. I think he sought the Ashwinders out to learn their secrets. Victor Rookwood, at least, seems somehow immune to Ranrock's loyalists.
Do you think Bardolph may have simply run off?
No. Bardolph's run that shop with Claire his entire life. He'd not give it up for anything. He swore he'd be back in a fortnight. My instincts are that he's been held captive, or worse.
I can certainly look out for him.
Any help would be appreciated. You might speak to Claire first. Perhaps she has some insights that I don't. I can tell you that Bardolph was last seen in the forest wearing a particular woolen jumper, one that Claire knitted herself. Claire will be at the shop if you'd like to speak with her.
Chips in the hat, please.
Upper Hogsfield is being terrorised by Ranrock's loyalists. It's not right.
Madame Beaumont, might I speak with you?
Yes. What about?
Mrs. Sprottle told me a little about your brother's disappearance.
Oh, dear Dorothy. She'd go looking for Bardolph herself if she could.
She mentioned dark magic in even the Ashwinders.
Despite my repeated warnings, Bardolph's been experimenting with dark magic near the edge of the forest. I thought perhaps he'd get it out of his system and it would gradually stop. But then one day, he didn't come home.
Could Bardolph have run off?
No, he'd never leave me here alone. He did speak of going to talk with Victor Rookwood. That worries me almost more than his attempts at mastering dark magic. Rookwood is as dangerous as Ranrock, in my opinion.
Is there anything your brother took with him that might help to track him down?
Only his satchel, journal, and a woolen jumper I knitted for him. That's all I can recall.
I'll let you know if I see or hear anything about him.
Thank you. How kind. I'd be so grateful to learn where he is. I know in my heart he's out there. Do be careful.
I should be going now. Thank you.
Bardo, Ranrock's loyalists are a menace. What can be done?
I couldn't help but overhear. Did you mention Ranrock's loyalists?
I did. Never imagined they'd act this deadly. I'm Claire Beaumont, by the way.
Nice to meet you.
Ranrock and his followers have set up camp here. No regard for our beloved hamlet or our livelihoods. Ruthless. My brother Bardolph dared to stand up to them and ended up in St. Mungo's. I'm simply at my wit's end.
How did your brother Bardolph end up in St. Mungo's?
Bardolph had spent the entire day handpicking herbs and roots for us. When a group of Ranrock's lot appeared and demanded the harvest for themselves, Bardolph refused. In their anger, they hurled him against a rock and robbed him. The moment he left St. Mungo's, he vowed revenge. I worry he may be dabbling in magic that he will one day regret.
You said Ranrock's loyalists have set up camp here. Where, precisely?
To the south, across the river. Last I heard, there were several loyalists in each camp. I won't go near them.
Why don't you simply leave the area for now?
Upper Hogsfield is my home. Bardolph and I grew up here. No, we are standing firm. Once my brother returns, then we shall decide what to do next. He's gone to seek Victor Rookwood's advice. I didn't approve of that idea, but perhaps in the end it will help.
I'm unfortunately quite familiar with Ranrock's loyalists. Perhaps I can do something.
Much as I would love to be rid of them, I wouldn't want you to risk injury or worse. Please be cautious. We should not have to live in fear. This is our home.
It seems as though things are getting worse. Best be on my guard.
Revelio!
Not sure how I'd fare in a little place like this.
Revelio.
No doubt Ranrock's loyalists intended to rob him.
New instruments are expensive, you know.
Aloha, Mora.
Revelio.
Come now, don't be stingy.
Aloha, Mora.
Mine now.
Revelio. Revelio.
This looks intriguing.
Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Seems a pleasant enough little place.
Revelio.
Are you in some sort of trouble?
Nearly attacked by wolves, I was. Only just escaped with my life. I need to be better prepared next time. Could use some thunder brew. I don't suppose a student like yourself would be in possession of such a thing?
Yes, I have some right here. Please take it and be careful.
Oh, thank you, thank you. I knew you had a good heart. I feel better already just knowing I have some thunder brew on hand. Please take this as thanks for your generosity.
Revelio.
You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented flu powder.
See if there's something you need. Thank you for your patronage. That's been a pleasure. Now there's a student who knows how to fly.
Revelio. Accio. Revelio. Accio.
handy resource indeed, your field.
Revelio.
I'm most pleased to be included.
Accio.
Confringo.
No one takes one of my own and lives to tell of it!
Accio.
Confringo.
Place
The doctor.
Accio.
I have overestimated you.
Confringo!
You fickle. You'll regret that.
Confringo!
Potato! Nice try!
Your life is here.
Confringo! Accio!
Careful not to get bit.
Accio,
Confringo.
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 Quick little kick.
Accio,
and to warm you up.
Confringo.
You will not survive.
Confringo.
Let's see you survive. Stupendous!
Confringo!
You don't protect us!
Glacier!
You fight for it!
Glacier!
To warm you up!
Confringo!
Confringo!
Accio! Glacis! Revelio!
Nice to see you, my young friend.
Revelio.
You've had too much fire with you if you think you can outdo
me. Aloha Mora. Accio.
Confringo. Aloha Mora. Revelio. Revelio. Aloha Mora. Revelio. Revelio. Lumos. Revelio. Lumos. Revelio.
Mind now, demiguys.
Revelio.
Wonder who lives here.
Revelio.
Could it be a Merlin trial?
Revelio.
Merlin trials won't get the best of me.
Revelio. Lumos. Lumos.
That'll be it for today. I know it took me a little while to do some of that, or to figure out the lock picking, but I thought it was kind of like Fallout, the Fallout games where you had to align all the things, you know, or press down the things. I just thought you had to align them, but I was wrong. But yeah, otherwise that'll be it for today, so peace out.